It's been a COVID time. So, how has been the COVID so far for you?
We are into sort of a brick and mortar business where there are actual physical centers and we're looking at small children. We were the first one that got impacted. In fact, even before the lockdown got announced, just as a precautionary measure, we sort of started locking down our centers. So for last 1 year, all our centers have been logged. We have gradually started reopening few of them only for daycare actually, but it's been pretty bad for us last 1 year.
I understand. I
So
understand.
we have what we have. I mean, of course, when you have situations like these, that's when you probably invent new possibilities. So we actually started doing some online activities and online preschool for small children. Never thought that 2.5 year olds will be there on a screen and doing their preschool, but that has been very successful, honestly. I think that has helped us survive last 1 year. We got to about 2,000 parents who are taking online preschool classes, and that has been a very good experience, honestly.
That's right. That's right. So I'm sure it must be a tough task, you know, managing 2.5 year kid over the online part.
Yeah, it is, and also to navigate through all the financial issues that are there. I mean, we had a team of 120 people, and then of course there were a team on the center. So it's been a very tough journey last 1 year. And the toughest part really is that just before COVID, we were at the peak of our game. We were adding roughly 10 centers every month, so we were right at the peak of our game, doing really really well in last 5 6 months before COVID. So that hurts. I mean, we've been trying to build this company for 7 years. Finally, we were at a point where we were an inflection point in a way where we would actually grow at a pretty rapid pace. So yeah, I mean, but then life teaches you something. I mean, I've seen this is my sort of third economic downturn that I'm seeing in my career. Well, first was in 2002, but then we had dot-com bubble, and then 2008, 2009, and then this one. And I've seen it both as an employee, as an employer. But this is like probably hurt us most, and probably made me learn most.
But I'm sure, you know, the kind of disruption that has happened over COVID, I'm sure with the kind of setup arrangement that you must have done, it will take you another, you know, at the faster speed when you will be actually in the real gear mode of your growth, isn't it?
Yeah, so certainly. I think eventually, we are much leaner in terms of our cost structure, and far more efficient. And I think, in general, in life, I think at least I realize the value of everything that I've got much more than I ever did. So yeah, it has been a humbling experience, and I think business-wise also, eventually, I think things will be much better. But of course, in a shorter time, it's just too much of a pain. I don't hope that there is another wave of COVID here, and we have to go through that pain again,
That's right.
because ours is a business that will get impacted again pretty soon. I mean, if we have a second wave as it seems, then it'll be difficult for parents to send the child. Though all the data says that there is no threat on child, but then as a parent, I understand people are anxious about their smaller ones.
That's right. So, I mean, the question is again the related one. So, I heard your previous story that you were into softwares. So, softwares to education and that to preschooling. Now, what made you believe that you should enter into this?
So very honestly, I am a problem solver at heart. I am an entrepreneur at heart. I honestly don't care which business I do. After doing Brickred, which is out and out technology company, I wanted to do something which is much larger in scale and which impacts much more lives. And I was very clear that who do I want to partner in this business, which is my closest friend Purvesh, and he was very clear that he wanted to do something in education. So we looked at the entire spectrum. Only preschool was the unregulated space. So we thought, let's enter into preschool, and that was a pain that I could identify with because I had smaller children at that point of time, and I've gone through that struggle of preschool, daycare. So I could identify that with that pain. So, you know, got into it honestly. And I'll be honest, I think initial couple of years were very challenging for me because even though I was running my last company in India, but it wasn't an Indian business really. I realized what it takes to actually become successful in India. It is far more difficult to actually make money in a business where you're serving Indian customers than serving, you know, US customers from India. You have to be conscious about every penny. And so, yeah, I mean, in a way, you have to change your DNA. So it has been a difficult initial few years. And I think I've asked a number of times myself a question, is this what I really wanted to do? But then I guess I'm in a very happy space now that I think I made a good decision because it allows me to impact several lives and especially children who, when they are in their most crucial early years where the brain development happens most. I think it is very satisfying, really.
Right. So, because at the end of the day, we have to be satisfied with what we are doing, and I'm pretty sure you are enjoying this.
And I get to use a lot of technology and marketing. Those are the two strong areas I have, and we've been using a lot of technology in our operations. So yeah, I mean, that way I get to use my strengths as well.
That's right. So I mean, this is a no further to that. It's been actually a follow up question. So as you mentioned, you know, you are in a serial entrepreneur. So, and the kind of a funding environment that I have seen from Paytm and Amazon and Flipkart and lots on. So major, I think the emphasis that I've seen, it's into GMV, you know, the kind of GMV they will be having, and accordingly, you know, the funding environment comes easy. So, but everything comes out to be on the dot, which is profits. So what is your take into, you know, managing all this? What would be your preference? Creating, having more GMV and then coming up to the profit model, or have to the sustainability, profitable, and then scaling up?
So I think depending upon what you are chasing and what kind of support you are getting, end of the day, people who, I mean, let's say I'm into business because, you know, there is a mission that I have to solve a certain problem. At the same time, I do want to create a large amount of wealth, not only for me, but for my shareholders, my employees. Now, in a modern era, the route to that is certainly probably one of the route, at least, is to actually raise large sum of money. And that happens when you're scaling fast. And when you're scaling fast, you can't keep up with the profits. You'll have to give up profits and possibly offer your product services at a little discounted rate and possibly spend a lot more in marketing and technology. And eventually, and a lot of companies have proven that eventually you can turn the wheel and you can actually be profitable. So I don't see any problem with that path. And I also see, I don't see any problem with the traditional path, which our parent took, wherein they were more focused on profits. So it all depends on what your goals are. I think in my last company, I was very clear that, you know, and the funding environment was also not that right when I started my last company. So I was very clear that we want to make it a profit-oriented company. And we were profitable for all of 9 years of operation before I sold that out. At Footprints, we've been very conscious about scaling. So we've not really, you know, thought about being profitable. We've always been thinking to scale. And depending on how much money we were able to raise, we, you know, sort of scaled to that degree. So I don't see any problem with any of the approach, as long as you're clear what you're chasing and if you're getting the support. I mean, you can't, if you're not enough funded and then you're trying to sort of fund from your own saved money, that's not a good thing to do.
I see. That's right.